Welcome to the Central California Conference Secondary Choral Performance. These young people have been at Fresno Evans Academy practicing as a group and also as individual choirs since Thursday evening, getting ready for this performance today. So we're so happy that you're here with us, both in person, also we're live streaming today. I am so proud of these young people. We have a total of 114 coming from five of our senior academies. They have worked very hard even before they got here with the various pieces that they'll be performing today. This is the best of the best of Advanced Education. And I just want to share some thoughts with you real quick. Coming out of Psalms 22, 3 through 5. The theme for our concert today is called, Thou Art Holy. We're living in the last days, aren't we? We have to stay connected to our God and to our Savior. In doing so, this passage talks about the journey of the Israelites, being faithful, being connected, making sure that everything that they do, each and every day, that God is in control. And these young people have blessed us during their practices. They've been in the churches today. They went into the area churches and performed. And every time that we listen to them, they're singing from their souls on connecting us to Jesus Christ as their personal Savior. So it's an open prayer today as you listen to the performance that you will draw closer. You will strengthen your own spiritual journey to connect to Jesus Christ as your Savior. And everything that we do and say today will be able to glorify God. The mission of our Adventist schools in the Central California Conference is to connect our young people to be disciples for Jesus Christ. And doing so, to connect others to the Seventh-day Adventist Church and ultimately to the Kingdom of Heaven. So thank you for your tremendous support. Thank you, parents, extended families, board members, church members. Everything that you do to keep our schools open so these young people can have that spiritual connection. We're grateful that you're with us today. God bless you.
I'm supposed to introduce people. So I'm going to start with our clinician, Doug Connect. And because he told me I could do anything I wanted, I'm going to ask Doug to come over here for a moment. Maybe he said I shouldn't do that. I'm not sure.
I said you know too much.
I know too much. I don't know enough sometimes. I don't know when to quit. So we'll do a quick question answer. Where did you do your education study at?
Southern Missionary College, Southern Adventist University now, and then Andrews University.
Okay. And what was the first year you taught?
1862.
Nope. Wrong. Lost.
I graduated and started teaching in 1977.
That's a long time ago. Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to question everything because...
I won't remember the answer.
You won't remember, no. But I had the opportunity to work with Doug my second year of teaching. And he was already this old, experienced teacher by 3 years or so.
Something like that.
He was desperate for someone to join his band. Because he asked me to join, which I did, and I enjoyed it because it's another connection with the students. And I think that's why Doug has stayed in music so long. First, he enjoys it,
yep.
But it's the connection with the students. And that's why Doug, Mr. Connect, Douglas, is here
you can
today.
Call me sir.
Yes, sir. Along with the clinician, and it's, you know, there's a lot of instruction that goes on with the students because I think one of the statements you made as while you were talking to the students was, I'm right. Everyone else may not think so, but I'm right because I'm the one directing right now. And if your director wants to argue with me, it doesn't matter. But when he's your director or she's your director, then they're right. That's the person you listen to. Because we all have differences. So I appreciate Doug's sense of humor, and he does have one. You can tell, right? Yeah. I don't. And I am just very happy that he was able to join us here. It ended up being that he's doing double duty in some cases. Mm. He needed to come in and help at one of our schools because the teacher needed to be gone. And he has been substituting since January
11.
So we're happy he's here and has led these students. And I'm looking forward to listening to this performance, not just by the combined choir, but each school has selected specific songs that they want to present, and I think it will be wonderful to do so. Now, that's enough for you.
Oh, good. I'll just sit over here.
You can sit over here. Lance, you don't have to stand up here because that would be too much over there, but you can, you know, wave to everyone. Lance is our accompanist, and he's an exceptional pianist and musician, and has worked in music for I don't know how many years, but he has made a difference at Monterey Bay Academy being there, and now he's at Central Valley doing something different, where he's actually working even closer with some of the students. And once again, all of us up here, all the music directors, we're educators. Our reason for teaching and working in a school is not to make us feel good. It's to develop relationships with the students so that we can assist them in developing relationships with God.
Now, as we start our concert today, this is not my typical stance. I am an avid runner. I run every day, anywhere between 5 to 7 miles, but a few weeks ago, I was injured. And so, as we started our journey on Thursday with the choirs and performing, I was on crutches. But these young people behind me, it's not only spiritual healing, I believe we have some physical healing because now I am using a cane, so it's getting a little bit better. So thank you, young people. So let's start together and let's pray. Loving Father, we ask your divine presence in the sanctuary today. Thank you for each and every young person that has put their time and talent into performing before you and before us. Thank you for their directors. Thank you for Mr. Connect, Mr. Downing. Dear Father, we want to go home. Until then, we want to be faithful. We want to glorify your name. And today, it is our hope and prayer that you partner with us, that as we listen to the performance, that we're able to draw closer to you and have a better relationship with you. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Our opening number features a solo. So I decided that rather than try to pick somebody from this mass of wonderful talent behind me, I asked each choir director to select a soprano, and we're going to have all five of them sing this together. And I'm going to do my best not to butcher their names when I tell you who they are. So bear with me. We have Janelle Sherrill, Eliza Pascual, Abby Huerta, Alina Litvinyuk, and Dovan Martella. Did I get it? Thank you. O Taste and See was written in 1953 by Ralph Vaughan Williams to commemorate and to be performed at the coronation of Queen Elizabeth II in England. The text from the Psalms speaks of the responsibility of leadership and that we are blessed if we trust in God to lead us. We had a conversation the other day about God's creation. And when we sing the idol of praise, and please notice the spelling of that word, it's not the I-D-O-L that we're asked not to pay homage to. It's the I-D-Y-L-L that speaks of the natural beauty of this earth. And we remember that after God finished creation, of all the rest of the world, he created man, not to put in the world, yet the world was created for us. And once everything was ready, then he could bring us home and put us in that garden. You'll recognize this text as, "This is my Father's world. Remember, he made it for you."
Good afternoon. My name is Diana Cefalo, and I have the privilege of directing this wonderful group of students from Monterey Bay Academy. I've just been having such a great time. Started as their teacher in January, and I've just been absolutely loving it. Today, when we were out singing at the church that we're in. We had a blast. We sang and we got to fellowship and eat with the church out at Madeira, and we had a fantastic time. Our first number for you is a spiritual Wade in the Water.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, and that was with our student accompanist, Natalie Baptist.
The wonderful things the Lord showed me in heaven I cannot describe. I saw there tables of stone in which the names of a multitude of the redeemed were engraved in letters of gold. After we beheld the glory of the temple, we went out and Jesus left us and went into the city. Soon we heard his lovely voice again say, "Come, my people, you have come out of great tribulation and done my will. You've suffered for me. Come into supper, for I, myself, will serve you." We shouted, "Hallelujah, glory!" And we entered into the city. And I saw a table of pure silver. It was many miles in length, yet my eyes could extend over it. I saw the fruit of the tree of life, manna, almonds, figs, pomegranates, grapes, and many other kinds of fruit. And Jesus said, "You must go back to earth again and relay to the others what I have revealed to you. Then an angel bore me gently down into this dark world. Sometimes I think I can stay here no longer. All this earth looks so dreary. I feel lonely here, for I have seen a better land.
Thank you. So, my name is Riley Lips, and this is A-Way, clearly. I would just like to say I'm really happy that I got to be a part of this school. The reason I'm even talking is because the things that we've gone through this year over our program, the fact that we're here is just God's grace. Amen indeed. Like, we lost our original music teacher, and just so happens he was retired. You know, 120, retired, still open. Now he's here. He moved here. Now he lives in a trailer behind a barn, was it? And I'm blessed. I went from this one school that didn't really seem to care about their students to this wonderful place that I now call my home, and in the words of my mother, my chamley. And I would just like to say that I am really blessed, and I hope you are all today, and this is my solo. Thank you.
When is my king a-coming? A-coming, a-coming. Lord, hear my cry.
The king is coming, my king is coming soon. The king is coming, my king is coming soon. The king is coming, my king is coming soon. The king is coming, my king is coming soon.
Lord, I am tired and heavy is my burden. I'm down in the valley staring at the mountain. You split the mighty waters of the Red Sea. Lord, will you split the rising waters around me?
The king is coming, my king is coming soon. The king is coming, my king is coming soon. The king is coming, my king is coming soon.
For
the Choral, for Moses, and
he showed up
for Daniel, and
he showed up. Well, he showed up for Moses, and he showed up for David, and he showed up for Daniel, down in the lions. Showed up, yes, he showed up.
The world is weary and heavy with its hunger. We wait on your promise no matter how much longer. Child will be born, the prophets will have spoken. Freeing the captives and healing all that's broken.
The king is coming, my king is coming soon. The king is coming, my king is coming soon. The king is coming, my king is coming soon. The king is coming, my king is coming soon. The king is coming, my king is coming soon.
I showed up for Moses and he showed up for Daniel and he showed up.
Mercy and peace and compassion roll like thunder.
I would be remiss if I didn't recognize
Mrs. Danica Mason, who is the music teacher at Armonia Union Academy. The interesting thing is she teaches in the same rooms I taught in 20 years ago. And now I'm back. And she taught them that. I didn't. I'm just trying to keep up. So, but for those of you who know, the last contact I had with her, she's doing well. And we're grateful for that. Do you remember the story of Ezekiel in the dry bones? Well, we're going to sing about dry bones. Don't be the dry bones. Because God will come and resurrect somebody to do the work if you don't, right? And he'll create an army out of what was once nothing. This is not the, you know, toe bone connected to the, and so on. It, you know, it's a little different. But you'll recognize the story. It's called Listen. With your permission, I don't need your permission, but I'm going to ask anyway. I guess they can't fire me, so it doesn't matter, does it? With your permission, we're going to sing a piece that's not on your program. I didn't put this on the program because I hadn't learned it yet, and then they taught it to me, and I fell in love with it, and you have to hear this. So, we're going to sing it. But I'm going to tell you a little story. And some of you have heard this. And some of you have heard me say it because you've been following surrounded churches and that sort of thing. But I saw online one time a while back, and I'm paraphrasing, but grandfather went out into the backyard and he saw his granddaughter over in the garden kneeling down with a pad of paper, and she was writing. And he quietly walked up behind her to see what she was doing, and she was writing words that she knew, and they didn't go together. There weren't sentences. It was just random words. And he watched her. She was very quiet. And then when she finished, she quietly just closed her notebook. And when she looked up, he said, "Sweetie, what are you doing?" She said, "I'm praying." He said, "But what does it mean? The words don't go together. They're not in sentences." And she said, "I know. I didn't know what to ask God. So I thought if I put all the words down on the paper, he'd be able to put them in order and he would know what I wanted to say." And so she took her prayer to God and let him make something of it. I hope you love this song as much as I do. It's called My Wordless Prayer, and our soloist is Trishelle Biko.
Let's face it, I don't really need that. Ask the students up there. I can be loud if I want to. Good evening. As our accompanist Madeline Seaton gets settled, I wanted to talk for just a minute. Doug Tess said keep it under 30 minutes. Is that right? Under 100, excuse me, thank you. Oh, sorry. The piece you just heard, Ipata DC, comes to us from South Africa, where the word translates to paradise, that thing we're all waiting for. The next piece of music has become quite near and dear to my heart. And as we have gone through learning it, slowly but surely, it's becoming near and dear to those behind and around me. Gwyneth Walker has taken the beautiful poem, How Can I Keep From Singing? And has put it in a way that so perfectly represents what's happening in our world right now. If you were to look on the back of your program, you'll notice that at the conclusion of tonight's event, there is going to be a special offering taken to assist those in Ukraine. Our friends in Europe need our help. They need our prayers. And I want you to pay attention to the words you're about to hear, because you're going to find that is so powerfully accurate. Enjoy.
I hear the mill boat distant song.
Thank you again. The last piece we'll share with you is a prayer for all of you, as well as all of you and all of you. And I'm sure I'll throw myself in too. Peace in the valley. Peace is a tough concept right now. The last 2 years were challenging enough. Then we had to throw some other things in the mix. But the beautiful part is that you and I have access to the peace that passes all understanding. Even when it doesn't make sense to be at peace, God says, have it anyway. I've got it under control. Meditate on that. Thank you so much.
Well, I'm tired and so weary.
to my heavenly home. No, never gonna walk this journey alone. No, never gonna walk it alone. No, never gonna walk this journey alone. The Lord will see me over to my heavenly home. Weary, pilgrim, please don't give up now. There's nothing coming near you that the Lord won't allow. If your feet can't travel one more mile,
let the loving arms of Jesus carry you.
For a while, for a while, for a while. No, never gonna walk this journey alone. No, never gonna walk it alone. No, never gonna walk this journey alone. The Lord will see me over to my heavenly home.
The devil may try to lead your heart astray,
and trip your feet to make you his prey.
But when temptation starts a closing in,
God will make a way to escape from sin.
Escape,
escape, escape. No, never gonna walk this journey alone. No, never gonna walk
it alone.
No, never gonna walk this journey alone. The Lord will see me over to my heavenly home.
Oh,
be not afraid, my friend. My God will always see you through. Afraid, my friend, my God will always see you through to the end. No, never gonna walk this journey alone. No, never gonna walk alone. No, never gonna walk this journey alone. The Lord will see me over to my heavenly home. No, never gonna walk this journey alone. No, never gonna walk.
Romans 8, verse 38. Actually, verse 35 says, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are all killed all the day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. I love this verse, and I'm sure you do, for I'm persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. An arrangement by Dan Forrest, The Love of God. Thank you.
You thought these were your kids. They're mine. For the next few minutes, anyway. And the longer I talk, the longer I can put that off. If you've been in a choir, you know there's always something that goes on between a director and the people on stage, and most of us out there never know what that is, but I'm going to let you in on a little secret. Are you happy? Tell your face about it. We've been told to go and find a private place. Your closet, maybe, where you can have some alone time with God. And we all have a place where we do that. Unfortunately or fortunately, depends on how you look at it. So often mine is in the middle of the night when I can't sleep and I'm lying in my bed. So I talk to God, and sometimes I'm angry with him, and I tell him. And then it's okay. And sometimes things are going well, and I try to remember to tell him those times too. But we all have a place and a time where we communicate with God. We want to talk about that place just a little bit as we sing for you, Down to the River to Pray.
have to relax. Keep it under 30 minutes. Okay. I have the privilege of doing some acknowledgments. And I don't want these people to wander away too far because I just have to call them back up and give them stuff. First of all, I am very thankful that Mr. Connect was here today and working with everyone. I just appreciate him as a person and as a leader and as a musician. So, Doug, come up here. So,
I've never been a person before.
I know, it's a step up. Yeah. Couple things for you, and you can look at those later. I also have something for your sponsors, because sometimes they get left out. And that's actually one of the key things, our sponsors that come along and sleep on the floor and drive and do whatever else they need to do. And so please give this to them.
I will do that.
Thank you. Lance. Lance, Mr. Downing.
Yeah.
Have to use the Mr. in front of there. I enjoy you as a person also.
Thanks.
And I appreciate taking the time to learn some more music, although I think it comes pretty easy to you, but there's still practice because you want to get it right. So I appreciate you being here and getting it right. And so we have a couple of things and a thank you card. Miss Somerville, Tiffany, oh, come down here. And if any of the other directors are up there, come down here. I will move on, but come back to you. Joel, are you around anywhere? Mr. Westberg? It's hard to get rid of. Come up here. See, your students appreciate you.
I bribe them well.
Excellent job. So thank you. CVCA had a pretty good-sized choir this year.
We are very blessed.
Yes, and so I appreciate that and the help that they were, or when you volunteered them, that they helped so well.
We are blessed.
Yes. So thank you very much. I have something for you and your sponsors that you listed. By the way, if any of you directors did not list your sponsor, too bad. But see me later, okay? Mrs. Cefalo. Oh, we'll get to you two later. I'm getting out of order here. MBA came from quite a ways here. And the big bus. Thank you for being here. And I know this was rather short notice for you because you just joined MBA, what, January? So I appreciate coming in at this last minute and giving your students the opportunity, and they have done very well. So thank you. And so I have something for you and only one other sponsor. Thank you. Tiffany, let's go back to you. Tiffany, yes. Bakersfield. This is someone who, when they came and said, well, who's going to do music, volunteered to do it. So that's the type of teacher we especially appreciate. So thank you. We have something for your sponsors also. Mr. Thomas. Now, the reason Neil is last is because he's at Fresno Adventist Academy, and they're the school that sponsored this at their campus, which means over the last few days, Mr. Thomas has been all over the place trying to make sure that all the keys are out and available to people and hopefully returned. Have they been returned? One or two? So, I happen to have Bakersfield with me because she's turned hers into me. So I'll give those to you at a later point in time. I also have the ones that were given to me, and I never did figure out how to use them. So, because I didn't need to, because you were there taking care of what we needed. So thank you, and your sponsor that you had helping to drive, I appreciate both of you very much. And Gail Norton, he's principal at FAA, so he gets to come up here too. He may say that he didn't do hardly anything, and that's not the truth, because there needs to be someone overseeing and getting the details right and talking to people that need to help. And so I appreciate that, Gail. Thank you very much. And I didn't give a card to the junior class at FAA, but they and their sponsors prepared wonderful meals, good variety, and thank you for doing that. And then last is Pastor Wagner. Come on up. This is your church. It's God's church, but this is the head administrator. Now, there's a lot of people that help, and I have something for them too, but I don't know that I had enough of that item, so I'm going to give them to you later, but this is for you to thank you for the church, and I will have something in just a few minutes for, as far as they go, to your team of people who have been all over the place working with the audio and the video and making this a great place for us to be. So thank you.
We were hoping to have had this concert last year, but what prevented it? COVID, right? That interesting word. So we've had it this year, and Mr. Corson, who's our Associate Superintendent of Schools for Secondary Education, has led the charge to make sure that this concert would take place this year, and we are blessed. So Mr. Corson, thank you so much for your leadership and for your ministry and coordinating this concert. Appreciate you very much. God bless you. It was mentioned earlier that we're going to take up an offering at the end of the concert, and that's for our brothers and sisters in the Ukraine. There's actually a total of 24 Adventist schools in the country of Ukraine, and at this time, there's only 23 schools that we're not too sure, but they're not open right now, and they're bringing in refugees and different things. There's one school that's in operation, and we're not too sure what's going on right now, but we've heard that some schools have actually been destroyed. So we need to remember, brothers and sisters, we have a total of 23 schools in Central California Conference. That means our schools throughout the conference, if we were in Ukraine right now, we would not be operating at all. So we need to remember the teachers and students right now, and we're going to have the monies that we're going to try to get to the Ukrainian Union to make sure that they can help out, support not only the schools, but also the refugees that they're taking in and anybody else. So please remember our brothers and sisters and our students in Ukraine. And young people, thank you. Thank you. Thank you from singing from your heart. Your performance today touched our lives and strengthened our souls and brought us closer to the throne of God. So appreciate each and every one, and we value you very much. God bless you.
Before we finish, because when we finish, I want you to leave here with the last thing in your mind is the music. So I'm going to finish now before we sing. I need to tell you what a privilege, what an honor it has been for me to work with your kids. Yes, I'm going to give them back. Thursday night, not so much. Yesterday, a little more. Thursday night was great. Not so much musically as in some other ways, but then it got better and better. And we have just grown musically, I think, personally. I have grown spiritually from being with these kids. It's been a blessing. I remember, how many years ago? 1997, I think, wasn't it, Ken? When we started the mentor-teacher program, and my wife and I were a part of that. And it's interesting to be able to say that at least two of the music teachers that are here now were teachers that I was able to mentor when they started. They didn't need any help. It just gave me a chance to talk to somebody once in a while. But we developed relationships, and those last a long time. And relationships with our students and their families go with us forever. If you watch closely, you may notice that I think I got something in my eye a little while ago. And I don't think it's gone yet. But when I hear these kids do what they do so well, it touches me. I hope it touches you also. I need to add my thanks, my gratitude, unending, as it were, to Lance for being willing to accompany. We've worked together several times on different things, and he's also a very talented director, but we can't trade places because I can't play. So if we're going to work together, it has to be, I can do chopsticks maybe or something like that, but thank you, Lance. It's so nice to know that no matter what we do, he'll figure out where we are and make us look good. And that helps a lot. If I could tag on just a little bit with what my friend Joel said earlier, there will be peace in the valley. And I don't know if you've been there yet, but I read the last chapter of the story, and I know how it ends. God wins. It just needs to happen soon. This afternoon, we have tasted and we have seen how gracious God is. We have rested in the creation that he's given to us and been rejuvenated by that, and we've been to the river or wherever it is that you go when you pray. And now it's time to go home. As we share with you, Thou art holy. I hope that it takes you to the very presence of God as we kind of sneak in a little bit. It's kind of a scary thing to think about, isn't it? God passed by Moses on the mountain. He had to shield him because he would have died otherwise, and yet he invites us to come into his presence. So we sneak in quietly, and as we get more comfortable, we we get a little more excited and we start making noise, and then we wonder, is that okay? And then we realize that our Father is there waiting for us, and we can come boldly and we can praise Him, and then we can leave just as quietly as we came in. And we want to leave you with that this afternoon as we sing, Thou Art Holy. Just in case you're wondering, it does say on your program, I believe, when we're finished, we will stay here for a few moments because you've been very gracious this afternoon, but I know some of you want pictures of your kids up here a little closer than what you could get. So we'll all stay here, and you can come and do that before we walk out and go home. But I pray that you've been blessed as much as I have this afternoon, spending this time together as we praise our God. Thou art holy.
invite you all to stand for closing prayer. Shall we bow our heads? Heavenly Father, we truly have been in your presence with the beautiful singing this afternoon, with praises to you as our Lord and Savior. We thank you for each one of the young people and the sponsors and so on who've been here and made this possible, that we can share in just a small taste of what it'll be like to meet together in heaven and be able to sing together to praise the Lord. We ask, Lord, now that as we go our separate ways, that you will guide us and keep us. May we not forget the message that we have heard today in music. May we have peace. May we be praying for peace for our brothers and sisters, and may we each one be ready that not one will be missing when we do see you face to face. We ask it in your name. Amen.
There is a black box in the back for the collection for the offering. So in the back as you exit, there is a black box.